I make money in my sleep.
We were able to step into our purpose, me and my husband, and now live out real estate investment to the fullest.
And I want people to understand how easy it is, how available it is, and that you can do it.
I was able to close on a duplex, and that one duplex has made me rent and mortgage free.
At the closing table, not only was I giving money to pay for it, I got checks in my hand walking away from the closing table.
The multifamily movement made by Jullien is the best program and damn.
Yo, this is where the multifamily movement started. Right here. This is my first triplex in Brooklyn, New York. I bought it in May of 2013. It literally changed the financial trajectory of my life.
I went from paying expensive rent in Brooklyn to now being paid expensive rent in Brooklyn with one single decision and one single move.
Now, when you go inside, you won't see any of the bells and whistles from HGTV. You will not see granite countertops. You will not see stainless steel appliances. You will not see that gentrification gray paint, you know, that repose gray or that agreeable gray from Sherman Williams. Y'all know what I'm talking about. None of that is on the inside. But because I had changed the lenses through which I looked at real estate, I knew that this was the one. I'm actually here in front of a beautiful triplex in Newark, New Jersey with Olivia and Jasmine. They closed on this property about 6 months ago. They're actually starting to do the renovation work on it. We're about to go inside and see what they're up to, how they're gonna force appreciation and their plans and strategy for this property and how they're gonna buy their next one. So come on, join us in on this tour of this triplex in Newark, New Jersey.
Good. These floors look solid too. You might want to just finish these floors.
What I discovered about American society is that there's actually four classes. There's the lower class, there's the middle class, there's the upper class, and there's the asset class. And only one class is actually free, and that is the asset class. The multifamily movement is multiple families coming together to create regenerational wealth and enter into what I call the asset class.
It's the whole family behind me. I told you it was a movement, right?
I pulled up on Larry Timms. He closed on this duplex right here not too long ago. And so we're gonna say hello. He's gonna tell you a little bit about his story and how he got this property right here through the multifamily movement. So come on. Mr. Multifamily.
What's up, Chief?
Oh my goodness. So this is it?
Yes, this is it, sir. This is my first duplex that I just closed on last year.
Yeah, oh my goodness.
I'm so happy to see it, y'all. How's it feel?
Good, good. It's nice to have a certain sense of sovereignty and all the benefits that come along with the multifamily.
Yeah, 100%, man.
Last year, it had a 21% cash on cash return, and then after the extra taxes and then the rent increase, it's like I almost gave myself a raise, and now it has a 34% cash on cash return.
This man knows his numbers, yo. This man knows his numbers.
All I care about is how many students get to the closing room, and that's what we're focused on with the multifamily movement, and this is why we have more documented closings than anyone on the face of this earth.
So one of the things that's special about the multifamily movement is that we have market meetups all over the country. That's where our students get together and self-organize, and they meet bi-weekly or monthly in certain markets to discuss what's going on in that market, what's happening with city planning, what neighborhoods are popping. This is what we do. We gather all over the country. This is not just a movement online. This is a movement in real life. The multifamily movement is literally a family, and you're gonna see that when we go inside. We don't believe in just personal development, we believe in communal development, and this is one of the layers of accountability that the multifamily movement offers that makes sure that students get to the finish line and to the closing room.
This is what we're doing. We're communing. We come together, we're analyzing properties, we're sharing knowledge, we're overcoming objections together, and that really is the difference right in this community. So
I am really excited to be closing on almost $1 million home, three family plus a bonus unit in North Newark in May, and be there with my colleagues at the gala, just being victorious.
But the first thing that we work on in multifamily movement is mindset. And once I change my mindset, it just opens so many doors for me. I closed on January 27th, and let me just tell you, it was an amazing day for me. You can't go back from that. Once you get that feeling, and you know that you were able to do that, and that you have the support of family, the sky's the limit.
The most impactful moment thus far is seeing the smile on my daughter's face when I tell her, guess what? Mommy got a multifamily, let's do it. Just the smile on her face and her eyes was like lit up bright, just set it all for me. Like, this is the reason why I stuck with it.
Over the course of a decade, Harriet Tubman freed 300 people by making 19 trips over the Mason-Dixon line and helping people get to freedom on the Underground Railroad. Well, guess what? I am the number one conductor on the Above Ground Railroad, which is multifamily real estate. To date, I've helped over 300 students close on $100 million worth of real estate all across the country, whether we're in New York, whether we're in California, whether it's Texas, my students are closing on a daily basis.
The next goal is to 10X that and actually get to 3,000. That will mean that we've acquired over $1 billion of real estate as collective with the multifamily movement. 100 million, I'm still on a grind. 100 million, I'm still on a grind. 100 million, I'm still in a. It's not about the money, it's more about time. Makes sense when you see how I spend mine. Burst through the ceiling, I'm feeling sublime. Can't leave the game yet, I feel like LeBron. 100 million, I'm still on a grind. 100 million, I'm still on a grind. 100 million, I'm still on a grind. 100 million, I'm still in a.
It's not a get-rich-quick scheme. It's a get-rich-guaranteed system over time. This requires patience. Some people, they join the program and they want to, I found a deal the next day. No, you did not find a deal. You don't even know what a deal is. You found a listing. We know the difference between listings and deals.
My mother was an anesthesiologist. She had done everything that she was supposed to do in the American dream. She had checked off every single box, went to school, got all these degrees, had great income, Mercedes-Benz, all of those things. And one thing derailed her entire life. And she ended up dealing with a mental illness. And when she lost her income, guess what happened? She ended up losing the home. Today, that home is worth $1.8 million. And me, as her only seed, as her only child, I will not be inheriting that property. Had she purchased a four family in Oakland, California, that asset would likely still be in our family today. And so that's actually what repelled me from actually going down the path of acquiring single family homes. And I knew that I wanted a multifamily home first.
You know, I know my parents said, you know, why don't you just get a single family home? You know, why does it have to be a multifamily? It's a lot of responsibility. You know, you want to be a, you know, a landlord, you know, and, you know, an investor, all these things. But it's been the most valuable investment that both of us have made in our lives.
So right now there's this negative perception of landlords. You hear movements like cancel rent and things of that nature. But every landlord is not a slumlord, right? I am actually seeking to take care of the people. And you have to really think about the importance and the value of a landlord. This is somebody who's saying, I'm going to think beyond just housing my own family, and I'm going to provide housing, as expensive as it may be right now. I'm going to seek to provide housing for other people who cannot afford to own a house at this moment in time.
He teaches us how not to be landlords, but love lords. They're like little mini parts of my family, and I have one of my tenants that was having a little bit of difficulty keeping up with her rent. She was 74. I let her pay what she was able to afford, and then we found a program during the pandemic that paid the balance for her. And so I didn't sweat the small stuff, and when you're generous to others, it comes back to you in spades. And those are the types of teaching that Guru Gordon teaches us.
And this is what we do in the multifamily movement. We are a community of ethical investors that are seeking to improve our community and buy back the block.
The current gap between white and black home ownership sits at about 30%. That's larger than the 27 percentage point gap that existed in 1960, before the Fair Housing Act was passed.
You realize that God's first gift to man was not life, it was land? God's first gift to us was not life, it was land. The land was here before we were even breathed life into. So there's something sacred and valuable about this land.
We had more land after emancipation than we own today. And here we are again coming to claim it. And this time we are not letting it go.
I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Cocaine quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA.
Why don't we hack houses like frat houses, where everyone living good for just a few thousand? Some will say it's lousy while they slaving proudly, spending one third of their revenue to pay for housing. living on your own, but you don't own shit. Can't even get a loan, student debt is a bitch. Thinking a high wage is the way to get rich, not if your cost of living rise directly with it. Trying to keep up with the Joneses, deep in debt till you croak. I'ma live just like the Jeffersons, pretend that I'm broke. Then I'll buy a multifamily, let the rents pay the note. Perhaps you could be my tenant, yo, that would be dope.